We'll be right back. Hello and welcome. I'm Laura Cornelius and you're watching the Global Poker League Summer Series live from Las Vegas. Yesterday was a day of clean sweeping. 9 points going to Mustafa Kanit and the Rome Emperors versus Jake Cody of the Las Vegas Moneymakers. And then in our second match yesterday, we saw 9 points for Pascal Lefrancois of the Montreal Nationals and he was playing David Kitai of the Paris Aviators. Today, just one match coming your way. It's going to be a good one. It's Sergey Lebedev of the Moscow Wolverines versus Joao Bauer of the Sao Paulo Metropolitans.
Hello, my babies, and welcome to the Global Poker League. It is the Summer Series. I am Joe Stapleton. He is Eric Danis, and we are coming to you live from the Cube in the GPL Arena in the Tropicana Business Park and Park and Fly in beautiful Las Vegas, Nevada. How you doing today, Eric?
Very good, Joe. The fact that it's a sort of cooler outside means it's going to be a good day inside for you and I. We won't die. It's great.
A lot less complaining coming from us today, at least for the first 5 to 10 minutes till it warms up in here. Eric, I found out something interesting about you this morning.
Yes?
You like to wear a lot of Lululemon.
I do.
Isn't that girl clothes?
No.
Are you sure?
You know, you can say it's girl's clothes until you put it on. You're like, yeah, I'm never taking that off. No.
No, I felt and that way about actual girl's clothes before. Just admit
that's
it.
That's true. No. But don't forget it's a Canadian company. And hey, it's Canada Day today.
Happy Canada Day, everybody.
I do like to support the Canadian product. But as a former obese man, yeah, one of the goals in life was to wear Lululemon.
Comfy clothes.
Good. Yeah. Makes you look good, too, the legs.
Look, I'm not going to lie. I've dressed up in women's clothing before, and it does feel nice.
So. Ask Kara Scott how I look in Lululemon, because she's taken to Twitter a few times to talk about that. So.
Oh. Well, I guess I'll have to go back through her archive, because I do love a good Kara Scott tweet. Eric, what's on tap today, GPL-wise? How are we celebrating Canada Day?
Yeah, let's celebrate Canada Day by celebrating Moscow and Sao Paulo. The guy that put this schedule together, me, didn't do the best of planning jobs, obviously.
No, but you did. You gave the Canadians a day off. Thanks for that, buddy.
You're welcome. Sergey Lebedev of the Moscow Wolverines coming off a very impressive score at the World Series of Poker, which he's done regularly in the past few years, playing Joao Bauer, who's making a return to the Cube after a 2-1 defeat to Fabrice Soulier just a few days ago. Two players that, Joe, have been really solid citizens in the GPL and scored a lot of points for their respective teams. So interesting to see this matchup today.
Well, speaking of points for their respective teams, let's take a look at the scores for the Americas Conference.
And we see the Sao Paulo Mets at a, some would say, surprising third place. You know, they were one of the teams that a lot of the critics weren't sure what would happen with this team this year. They fared very, very well, Joe. They had a scorching start to the summer series. Felipe Ramos picking up a ton of points for that team early. And they keep on keeping on. They are now, 7 points clear on fourth place New York. You know, a lot of points ahead of a playoff spot. So Sao Paulo looking good at the moment. And if they can score well in these last two summer series heats, it does look that they'll set themselves up to not only, you know, get a playoff spot, but maybe even contend to maybe join LA at some point for second place.
Excellent. Let's flip on over to Eurasia.
And here they are, the mighty Wolverines, sitting in first place with a game in hand on second-place London.
1 point lead, though, on London.
That's right, but they do have an opportunity to add 9 points today, so they could be 10 points ahead of second-place London when all is said and done. Hong Kong are the last team from the Eurasia Conference to be in the Cube this heat, so they'll have their opportunity to hit first place should Moscow struggle today. So a lot to, you know, the team is very comfortable, Joe. It's the fact is, though, there's only a 20-point difference between Rome and Moscow, so they still are only 20 points ahead. A lot of points are available, especially when you go back to online play. So at some point, the team will have to add those points. So very comfortable right now, but if they one misstep or two here to close out the summer series, and Moscow could be in trouble. So a lot on the line here for Sergey Lebedev.
Well, I think that they're comfortable for a playoff spot, certainly, but you want to stay in first place, right? I mean, there's a little bit of pride on the line. So I would, you know, obviously want to get some distance between myself and London because I think they got a real strong team. So I think that you need to really make sure that you put as much distance between yourself and them.
Yeah, and we saw it yesterday with Montreal. They should be on cruise control, but they refused to be. And 9 big points from Pascal Lefrancois against David Gattai, one of the game's best. Really, the rich get richer, and I think Moscow wants to follow suit. Moscow, another team that was a little disrespected when the season started. Not many people seeing them, contend, and here they are in first place, and really one of the most gelled teams, actually. The players are really a cohesive unit, and that's no surprise, given that Anatoly Filatov is leading this bunch, and he takes things quite seriously when it comes to the GPL.
I mean, obviously, he is taking things very seriously because he is here. He is in the building, and not many managers have shown up to support their players in the cube. Chris Moneymaker,
who?
I'm calling you out yet again. However, instead of focusing on the negative, let's focus on the positive. Anatoly Filatov is here, and he's with his player, Senior Lebedev. And two of them are down with Laura.
They are indeed manager of the Moscow Wolverines, Anatoly Filatov, and of course Sergey Lebedev, who will be playing today. Let's talk through, first of all, what's been going on. You are one of the managers that is really hands-on with all of your team. You've been here for pretty much all of the matches, in fact, that the Moscow Wolverines have been playing. You've been in the cube playing a few games. Talk us through what you've been trying to teach Sergey.
Yeah, actually, we were interrupted by you, Laura. I lead against Sergey.
I'm sorry.
Like 2-1 or something like that. The first time we played on GPL platform, he won 3-0 against me, so I have to take revenge, but now he will play with Joao, so yeah.
But as usual, I was playing very strong in all ins, so I think no chance, Anatoly.
Maybe he's too good.
Talk us through playing against Joao Bauer. Have you ever played against him before?
To be truth, I can't remember. Yeah, so maybe online.
We'll check with him.
Too many guys. He don't care. He don't remember. I remember, Joao. We played a lot online.
It's been a great start for the GPL for Sergey, though. You must be proud as a manager of him.
Yeah, it was a great start. He lost 3-0 to Nenenenko.
No, but I mean the last game that he played.
Yeah, he played well against Timothy and other guys, and he won 2-1. So, I mean, like, that's why I decided to put him again in the cube, because, like, if he lost 3-0 again, I would, you know, doubt about Sergey.
No, 3-0.
No.
You know.
Yeah, but still, I won just 4 games and lose 5, so okay. I need to run more
to
and
run
more.
Better. And actually, he arrived to WSOP like a couple of days ago and made the final table. The first he cashed in 10K 6 mags, an easy game, and then the final table in 5K turbo. So I hope that he show all his skills here too.
How important is it to be, you know, in a good frame of mind, winning things in order to win more things and to win this game here as well?
To be truth, I hoped to play heads up for bracelet in 5K, so I didn't do it. I need to show now how I'm good in heads up matches.
And the Moscow Wolverines are top of the conference right now, just by 1 point though. Are they going to stay top of the conference by the end of today?
I will try to do my best. I want to see always Moscow Wolverines on the first place.
Okay, and I guess you agree.
Yeah, I agree. I definitely agree, because we play today and the other team, they play next day. So we'll be on the top on the list no matter what happened. Like.
All right, confidence coming through here. Sergey about to play game one in the cube. Back to you guys at the desk.
I really like this Russian team. I think that they got the know-how and the elbow grease and the wherewithal, and they're willing to put in the effort. We got a coach down there. They say all the right things. I don't know if anyone is more aware of the cameras than Anatoly Filatov. You notice he'll be like,
"That's right."
With half, and also he's the transition from man to machine seems to be going very
going well
for him, as he now has a microphone attached to his face.
Apparently expected on stage with J-Lo later on tonight with
yeah.
his mic setup. Yeah,
that's
he'll
a fantastic
backup dancer.
But that's how much he wants it, right? That he's willing to wear a ridiculous microphone just to be on camera.
What's also amazing is that he'll start the show as a backup dancer to J-Lo and end the show as the star, and J-Lo's going to take
a
back seat.
Oh, like a total transformation.
Yeah, she'll take a back seat.
Into Jenny from the block. Let's take a look at Sergey Lebedev's individual stats.
Yeah, Joe, when Lebedev was drafted, I think a lot of people were surprised by that draft pick. We shouldn't have been, because he's really been one of the stars of the league, showing his personality off in a lot of the online play. So really exciting to see him in a cube today. The boys just mentioned a huge run in the 5K turbo event where he finished in a top 10 finish, just ahead of Phil Hellmuth and Kushman Davia.
Mondavia,
who won that event. A guy that spends a lot of time in Montreal. And here he is, 12 points, tied for 44th. He's only played three times in the league. And as Anatoly mentioned, it really was a rough start. Lost 3-0 to Nananoko, who, as we know, does that a lot. But then he's, you know, two solid performances. He's won his last two heads-up games, really helping that team elevate itself to first place. So great, weak start, but things have really turned around for him. 44% success rate, as Sergey just mentioned himself. In games, he's 4 wins, 5 losses. But in matches, he's 2-1, and that's where it's most important.
All right, let's take a look at the stats for his opponent today. Joao Bauer, star of Portuguese 24.
He's played 7 times already, Joe. It'll be his 8th time in the cube today. That ties him for
It's a long day for Joao Bauer.
25 points, 15th in the league, and as a wild card, those are great numbers. 13 points in 6 max, 12 points in heads up, 2 wins, which ties him for 28th. Lebedev also 2 wins in the cube. 2 wins in heads up play. 45% success rate. As we mentioned, he did lose his cube debut to Fabrice Soulier of the Paris Aviators, but a little rough one, where wasn't that match where the last game lasted one hand, and that was it. That's all she wrote. So I'm sure Bauer is looking for a revenge today.
That was the day that Fabrice came in to replace Davide Kitai, correct?
Yes, literally at the last second, yeah.
So yeah, that last match was a quick one. And that, Eric, before we get things going down in the cube, how are you going to celebrate Canada Day today? The traditional smoking of the maple syrup?
Yes. Maple syrup. We do maple syrup baths. We don't.
Riding a horse backwards into the pea soup fields?
I'm looking for Canada geese and beavers down here, too.
Oh!
Yeah. Want to party with them.
You know, everyone wears those Canadian coats all over the world, too.
Yeah, those really do bad things to animals, so let's
Oh, really?
Yeah, they're going to have to change those practices.
Sorry.
They've been caught.
Oh. No, but what are you actually doing for Canada Day?
I'm here at the GPL.
And then?
The Rio All Suites Hotel and Casino.
What does Canada Day even mean, actually? Was that the day you won your independence from upstate New York?
It's an excuse for us to drink beer and have a barbecue.
What is the history? Do you not know it? Am I embarrassing you right now? Because you
don't know, but it's
I want to know what the history is of Canada Day.
It's day one of our confederation. Yeah, July 1st, 1867.
Oh, you couldn't just let us have July, huh? You got to bump us by 3 days. Fourth of July, 3 days later.
Yours is fake.
Can we just move yours to February or something?
Like, how did they do yours, like, before Tom Cruise had an Oscar-worthy performance? Like, did that exist? Because he's born on the 4th of July.
Yeah, that was the name of the movie. Yeah, mm-hmm. Have you ever seen it? Do you know anything of My Country and My People?
Yeah.
It was the signing of the Declaration of Independence that day.
I know.
Eric.
No,
I was trying to explained how my day works.
I was trying to make a dumb joke that did not exist before Tom Cruise's amazing performance.
Well, clearly
was it amazing?
Did.
It's been a while.
I've never seen the movie.
Really?
Maybe that's where the disconnect is here.
Oh, so you're giving me crap about the 4th of July, which you're bringing up, and you've never seen the movie and I have?
I've seen Independence Day.
Oh.
Which is, as far as I'm concerned, the superior movie that references the 4th day of the month of July. Sorry. Our producer is very excited to tell me that the players have made it into the cube and we can stop talking about
this. That's because he's already celebrated his independence from 4 countries. He lives everywhere.
He's been all over the place. Right. But let's get down to 2 guys that are not celebrating their Independence Day. Say they're here to battle it out in the cube. Let's get on down there.
Okay, let's go.
Let's go, Sergey.
First hand, I raise 1,000.
First blood goes to Sergey Lebedev. Quick reminder, chip stacks start at 50K apiece. Blinds go up every 4 minutes and they start at 2 and 400. Those clocks ticking down, you see there, that is their total time bank for the entire game. We are going to play 3 games. That gets reset every time. When that clock reaches 0, you're in the hot seat. 4 seconds to make every decision. Otherwise, you get folded.
That's for a bet. So
before 75.
It's 3-bet. Should get a fold from Joao. Tell me who you're working for!
Thank you, Pedro. Tells me Independence Day is with Will Smith, not Tom Cruise. I wasn't talking about Independence Day. Thanks. I was talking about Born on the 4th of July, a Oliver Stone movie?
Correct.
Hey.
Eric, question for you coming through on Twitch, which, by the way, is at twitch.tv/GPL. Who are these players? Ask Poker Monster Maniac.
Great question. Sergey Lebedev, yeah, monster on the circuit, plays a lot of those high roller events, but also is running great at the World Series of Poker now for a few years. His biggest cash was last year. 8th place finish in the WSOP one drop high roller. Jonathan Zuemel, happy Canada Day. He won that event.
Jonathan.
Anthony Zeno finishing 7th. Also, he's also playing. Sergey told us that actually his specialty is heads up cash games, so it'll be fun to see him in the cube, how he survives. Joao Bauer, who's very much accomplished online, over $2.4 million in winnings in online tournaments. Little less experience live, $620K in live winnings.
Joao Bauer is also the most decorated officer ever from Portuguese CTU.
I agree.
Joao wins this pot with his pair of kings, gets a fold.
Jack Bauer, of course. Kiefer Sutherland, happy Canada Day, Kiefer. And the blonde. The girl next door.
Alicia Cuthbert.
Happy Canada Day, Alicia. I forgot your name, but...
She's going to celebrate by dating the entire Maple Leaf starting line.
He's now in Ottawa.
Oh.
Dion Phaneuf. Happy Canada Day, Dion.
Happy Canada Day, buddies. Thanks for having me.
Man, Pedro's struggling today.
Oh.
I'm getting trolled by my own manager today.
Who's in attendance?
He's out there. This Canada Day stuff is great. It should be in your act. It can't possibly be a compliment.
<can't> be true.
My dinner button.
Sadly, Joe Stapleton has been dropped by his agent here live on national television.
King high, still the best hand for now. If I could talk about Sergey Lebedev from a personal perspective, Eric just rattled off his stats, his accomplishments. I've met the guy a few times. Really nice dude. Like him a lot, and he's a huge poker fan.
Yeah. Also, we've seen, if you've watched the online play, you've seen Sergey's family, his wife and daughter, I believe, have been on. Highly caffeinated. This is national television? Well, yes, Poker Central. International.
What is television anymore?
That's right. Also on the Ocho.
No.
If your cable provider goes up to channel 1100, there's a good chance you might have Poker Central.
Line's going up.
Joao's jack's good here. And Sergey folds the turn. Blinds up to 3 and 600. That's spooky.
Hey, Sergey.
Hi, buddy.
Hey, man. I said your wife was lovely. I didn't say anything else.
Maybe just stay away from the
topic
entirely.
Who are those three guys? Why are they wearing suits? It's hot. Oh, God. Joe, I know you're not a big sports nut, not a big ESPN guy.
No, I am
guy.
Now. No, it turns out I've overnight become a really big sports fan.
I forgot about that. Joe, I know you're a big sports guy.
Yeah.
Which totally ruins my setup of Stephen A. Smith looking for a co-host now that Skip Bayless is out at First Take on ESPN. And I was going to say, just like Skip Bayless, you don't know much about sports. But I would lie, of course. I lie.
And the only difference between knowing stuff about sports and not knowing stuff about sports is just pretending in the volume of your voice.
It's yelling. Yeah, of course. Loud noises. You know, the audience today is filled with Brazilians and Russians. I'm sure they're really excited by this ESPN talk.
The last time I was in a fantasy football league, I got really upset because they wouldn't let me pick Jeff Hostetler.
The Haas.
I definitely had a Jeff Hostetler starting lineup toy. I'm almost positive when I was a kid. I had Phil Sims and Jeff Hostetler. And Lawrence Taylor. I got that one in the package somewhere back at home. That one's worth a couple of bucks. What's happening here? Does anybody win this pot yet? Check, check on the end. Nine high wins it. Nah, it's a pair of sixes. Come on. It's an upside down nine.
Lawrence Taylor has done well for himself since... Oh, no. He has not. Wait a minute.
Well, he invented the sandwich.
He did.
With him, with his partner. Who's somebody from the NFL that started with B?
Boomer Esiason.
Boomer and Lord made the BLT.
Yeah, Boomer Esiason, a big New York sports radio legend now.
Top set for Sergey. Second pair for Joao.
This is impossible.
And for some reason, Scott Huff is trying to FaceTime me while I am live on the air.
What an amateur. The Andre Akkari's for Sergey, that is really rubbing it in the faces of all Sao Paulo Mets fans.
Might have been a butt dial. Scott taught me this thing that when somebody butt dials you, you just talk to their butt for a while. Ask how the butt's doing. I'll talk to your butt. That's what Scott always said. How much does Joao like this nine? You know, I really think the safe player is to check back your set of aces. Risky. Thin.
Lebedev, don't play it safe.
Thin. Slothra says I should answer Huff. Maybe it's an emergency. One that can only be solved live on the air.
That's right.
In the cube. Quick, I need a soundproof, opaque room. Nice fold, Joao.
Joao's second time in the cube, both times sporting some LeBron James gear. Oh. Is that your agent taking a picture?
I don't think that's him.
Okay. Be sort of weird that he's taking a picture of the cube and not you, since...
I would like to wish a happy anniversary to the Benders. It's their 30-somethingeth. I probably should have got more information from him before I started down that path. Anyway, happy anniversary.
Congratulations.
You know what I did for my parents' 25th anniversary is I had a clock engraved, commemorating, and it was set to 25 wonderful years, and then I had him draw a line through the word wonderful.
That's pretty funny.
Joao's started with the best hand, flops the best hand. Can't be too mad at this flop. Sergey checks it, maybe giving up already. He's gotten a lot of free shots at cards and manages to hit nothing. Joao's taking a pretty passive line in this hand, and Sergey is going to fold. Lines up to 4 and 800. Big suited ace for Sergey. Joao's probably going to peel with his queen. He sure does. Flops a diamond draw. He's not too likely to be in love with it, though. Reminder, guys, you can join in on the fun. Talk to us, twitch.tv/GPL, or you can tag your tweets with the hashtag GPL. Oh, turns out your hashtag has been completely commandeered, by the way. You're now competing with the Gay Polo League. Not a lie. GG, GPL. The Gay Polo League has come to town and you are out. Sometimes in the world of hashtags, you are in and sometimes you are out.
Good on the U.S. Polo Association to
Do you think it's the people or the horses that are gay?
Oh.
Right?
Oh, right.
They should be more specific.
Oh. If it's the horses, I'm suddenly interested in seeing what
happens. As far as I'm concerned, the preference of your horse is none of your business. Just saw a shot of the crowd a few moments ago. Joao's got some people here. Sergey obviously has some people here.
Yeah, Sergey nervous because he's got his manager here. And unlike you, Joe, his manager can fire him.
Check, check. And Sergey, rivers are straight. Okay. Math Maestro is back with us. Sergey just checks on the four-card flush board. Obviously, pretty tough to get value there. Math Maestro says this atmosphere is very different from the talkative Igor versus BK scenario we had. Much more suspenseful. Hmm. Oh, okay. I like a chattier match, but hey, if you can see the glass being half full of no one speaking, then that's great.
Hey, we did see 6 minutes of Davide Kitai not saying a word yesterday, which was very intense. By the way, Joe, I was at the Rio after, and that match was on replay at our GPL booth.
Yeah.
And there was like 20 people there, including Antonio Sfondiari, who said there was no way that Davide Kitai could fold that hand. So,
did he fold? I don't remember what happened.
No, he had called, yeah.
Yeah.
He also said that other guy is pretty good. That was Pascal Lefrancois, so...
Antonio said Pascal Lefrancois is pretty good?
Yeah. Did not know him.
High praise from the magician.
Yeah, Antonio's been stopping by the booth every day, taking a look at the action.
Does he ever talk about me? We're pals now.
Are you?
Yeah.
Buddies. You are, yeah.
We do that show together. Yeah.
Wait. Does that mean that I can say that Helmuther and I are pals because we worked together that one time?
With Phil, it takes a couple dozen times before you start to register with him.
But can I tell friends that we're pals?
Yeah, sure. All right. They'll never find out.
That's true. Oh, Phil and I, yes, we talk about things all the time.
Both players flop a three. Joao's got the better three. Sergey turns an up and down draw. Doesn't get there on the end. He's left with five high. Not much chip movement between these two. If you check out the chip-o-meter, Sergey only up a few big blinds where he started. Joao only down a few. Winds up to 500, 1,000.
Joe, reminder that we are off tomorrow. Can't wait to hang with you at the pool at the house. And on Sunday, we are back at 11 a.m. Weiyi Zhang making his cube debut, being thrown to the wolves against Olivier Busquet, who is going to be very happy to be in the cube for the very first time.
I'm not hanging out with you at the pool at the house.
What do you mean? It's Saturday, we're off.
I'm going to rehab.
Oh. It's good that you're getting that
Why
help.
Do you think my manager's here? He's here to take me to rehab. No, I'm going to rehab at the Hard Rock pool. And the thing is, it's not the cool party it used to be, so the tables are real expensive. Inexpensive.
Inexpensive, yeah.
That's why I could afford it, because I'm going to like the pool that cool people used to go to.
Oh, it's going to smell of coolness from 2007.
I mean, I don't want to say that I've had a hard time with ladies this summer, but I'm thinking of jumping in the hot tub there just for the chlamydia.
Joe, at what time do you want me to show up tomorrow?
You know what? You just text me tomorrow.
Oh, okay, I'll text you.
Why don't you just text me tomorrow?
You should give me your number. You've said it a few times.
No. I mean, direct message me on Twitter. I'll have to follow you, actually, for that. Man, how do I get out of this?
He doesn't follow me, just so you know.
I will follow you now that we're friends. I only follow friends on Twitter.
Thanks, buddy.
Has to be someone that I hang out with on the regs. Otherwise, I gotta keep... There's too much social media.
You're right.
I can't handle it all.
Now, just to be forewarned, my tweets are about hockey, mostly. And some poker stats, which, you know, you love now. You're, like, addicted to those.
Oh, yeah. No, I love those.
Joe woke up this morning and said, Eric, give me the love on Lebedev. Told him, hey, 7th place finish in the 5K Turbo just a few days ago. Davide Kitai 23rd in that event. Timex 24th. Phil Hellmuth at the final table. Fun final table.
Sergey's clanker still good as he value bets the river.
hope you had...
Joao calls.
Oh. Nice end.
Thank you.
Sandy Sanchez says, Joao looks like he used to yell at his mom for interrupting his video game. Who didn't? Actually, I didn't. I was terrified of my mom.
Hey, you know what's better than getting kings one hand? Getting kings again the next one.
Back to back kings.
I had the same hand.
Hey, who gave our boss the password to the Twitch account, by the way? He's back on there.
Oh, no.
He needs to be in a meeting.
Oh, God. What's he doing?
Guys. I got a little thing going. Okay. Hey, he's talking about her. Yeah. Sad that this is Richard's last day.
It's part of my contract that I need to look at myself every 15 minutes, so... Now that my boy Ted's here, everyone's like, oh, God, what are all the different Stapes riders? Is that really our boss on the GPL account?
Yeah.
His accent
Hans
is
would never.
His accent's not as strong in the Twitch chat.
And by the way, we would share his shower. That thing is pretty huge.
Is it big?
Yeah.
I haven't been in his room.
Pretty big. Oh, he had me there this morning.
Okay.
Leave it there. Let's just say one of the two of us got a raise. Not monetarily.
I'm just going to let that hang there. Joao, three betting is three high and pretty much whiffs this flop. Well, does catch good on the turn. That is good enough to be the winning hand at the Mo. Luthith never Luthith.
Yes, Sloth, I've been at boss's shower just talking stats. Sad.
Come on, Joao.
Boop. Hope boop, you have ace eight.
Sergey checks behind for his showdown value, but is going to find that Joao had a pair of deuces.
The FOMO cheers.
I should have pre-flop. Don't expect it. Lose for bad.
Well, gets no action on his ace four suited. He's back up to nearly 30 big blinds, which are now at 6 and 1200. A couple of playable hands here. Heads up. Sergey with ace high and a wheel draw. Joao hits a pair. That pair is good. So on Canada Day, is it just recommended or is it law that you have to visit your local... I'm not even going to... go there. I'll do a different one later. It's fine.
It's more in parks and stuff. It's more festivals, a lot of music.
Joao Rivers trips. I really didn't think that one through.
Your agent just called. That gig has been canceled.
It's over.
Yeah. Actually, this gig is about to be canceled too, Joe.
What's he doing? What's happening? He's like punching in numbers and then reversing the ship.
Good bluff.
Good bluff and goodbye. What I was trying to ask is, do you all get together and sing Alan Thicke songs?
Hey, it's better than Robin Thicke songs.
We all get together, sing that Growing Pains theme song.
Oh, yeah. Which one was that again? Help me out. Just start it off, and I bet you I can sing it, but...
I can't at the moment.
Remember the mom? Joanna Cairns, I
believe? Cairns, yeah.
Cairns, yeah. That's a good mom. Kirk Cameron? He became a kook. Am I allowed to say that just because he's, like, highly religious? And, All right. He became God.
He became passionate.
Passionate about Christ. Okay.
Hey, man, those... what movies are those? The Taken Away? Sweat? What are those movies he does?
Yeah,
that
those
series
are pretty bad, yeah.
Armageddon movies.
Yeah.
Left Behind.
Left Behind, yeah. Yeah. Well-funded, those things, which is kind of scary.
Mm-hmm.
Sloth, are there fireworks shows on Canada Day? Of course.
Hey, there's some Canadian show that mentioned Poker Stars, actually, like a sitcom. It's like these two hillbillies sitting out front, out by their truck, and then these two preppy dudes pull up, and it's actually really, really funny.
I know what show you're talking about. I've not been able to see it because it's on a specific Netflix-y type chain in Canada. Yes. Darn.
I thought that show was real, like the 5-minute clip I watched, I thought it was quite funny.
It does look very funny, yes. About rural Canada. Did not realize they talk about Poker Stars.
So it's Slothro with that Show Me That Smile Again. Don't waste another minute on your
Don't
crying.
Don't waste another minute on your crying.
And Ted weighs in saying Kirk Cameron starred in Courageous, which made over $30 million.
You realize how scary that is? That a movie that...
Isn't
the
Passion,
of the,
isn't
world
the Passion of the Christ like the all-time... Yeah.
One of them.
Another big pocket pair for Sergey. Aces...
He's had aces twice, kings twice, and if he had kings here, he'd be in way better shape.
He doesn't need them.
He doesn't need
as
them.
As it turns out.
See, 1967, John Newcomb. I was right.
Letter Kenny is the show that I'm referring to. Thank you, Jared,
yes.
On Twitch.
Thank you. It does look very funny.
Joao ditches it. Not Trailer Park Boys, which I have watched,
no.
And I will admit, it took me some time,
and then I
started liking it, but it is really stupid.
I've never been a big white trash comedy guy. I've never been a big Roseanne guy. And yeah,
okay.
I'm not big on that. But Letterkenny does look very funny.
Joao's been put all in by Sergey's ace 5. He is up against the ropes, just 11 big blinds, 800, 1600.
Not shockingly, Laura Cornelius chimes in that she used to love Roseanne.
I was a big Roseanne fan myself.
On the flip side, I used to be a big Coronation Street fan.
Come on.
Well, my grandmother would always watch it.
Joao all in. Sergey forced to fold the 9 high. We are just waiting for that confrontation here in game 1. Blinds 1,000, 2,000. This could be the one. Oh. Sergey is going to put Joao all in. And Joao says, let's go, vamo.
Ace.
Up and down draw for Joao. Lots of outs now.
Lebedev asked for the ace.
Joao hits
ace.
One.
Spade. Ten.
Ace. Still ten lots of ways for Joao to lose this. That ain't one of them. Joao doubles up.
Vamo.
Woo.
Look at Anatoly just sitting next to them, too. There might be, he's in the supporters section of the Brazilians.
It's a dead heat right now, Brazil versus Russia, as to which country I'm eventually going to order my wife from. It's a real race situation.
Hey, what's your agent texting you now? Oh.
I think
sorry.
He's texting Alex. Cut his mic!
We at the GPL never cut mics, Joe.
I think on Canada Day, you guys should do a toast to Reg. like that from that Kids in the Hall sketch, to Reg.
Now, Kids in the Hall, that is something I got into.
It was probably my first favorite sketch comedy show.
It's the,
I'm crashing your head, crashing it.
Most brilliant sketch comedy.
My dad didn't want to let me watch it, though, because he goes, is that the show where they dress up like ladies?
Yes.
He didn't like that. He was not a fan of the fact that they dressed in drag.
Oh, yeah, a lot of drags. Can you pluralize? Can I say drags? I meant drag-ish outfits, but you're right. Yes, a lot of them. I know you're too young, and so was I, actually, but SCTV, is that something you actually... know about it?
I do know about it, and I was fortunate enough that when I worked on Mad TV, I worked with some of the former writers from SCTV. Cool. I was for a while, I was friends with Martin Short's daughter in LA, so I got to hear like a lot of really cool stories and be around some of those folks. Very lucky. My first 10 years in LA. This is an amazing story, right? I'm over at her house, and nobody's home. Marty's not there.
God, you said Marty.
Everyone just calls him Marty. Like I've never even met him actually. But that's what everyone just calls them. So I'm at her house, and there is a pack of photos on the counter from like the drugstore, right? From CVS. Yeah. And I pick them up and start flipping through them like, oh, there's Steven Spielberg sitting next to Steve Martin, who's playing the banjo. Oh, there's Tom Hanks and Dennis Miller. There's Larry David and I can't remember who else at this point. I'm like, what are these from? And she's like, oh, that's my parents' Christmas party. And this is like late November. She's like, that's from last year's Christmas party. She's like, I was like, this is incredible. She's like, do you want to come? And I was like, absolutely I do, yes. And then I ended up being home for Christmas myself while the party went on, so I didn't get to go.
Oh.
Good friend, Catherine. Joel flops top pair. And we are getting pretty shallow here. Shallower than a Kardashian, that's what I like to say.
It's pretty shallow.
26 big blinds is the chip leader.
Wow, quick call. Lebedev.
That is going to be the change in the chip lead. Joao now out in front. Blinds 12 and 2,400. This match is about to be all skill. Here we go. This is going to be the one. Your race situation.
Let's go.
Like the Kids in the Hall... versus Kenny versus Spenny. One of these two hands has a slight mathematical advantage. The ace pairs.
Queen is a cat.
Joao needs a five. No five. Double up for Sergey. That is going to cripple Joao Bauer.
Two BBs.
This is the scene where Joao Bauer is being Portuguese tortured on Portuguese 24. And there's no way he can get out of this one.
I guess since this is Canada Day, we should say that Joao is bound down to three Biebers.
Biebers! All in and a call. Joao hits a seven.
Nice. Four.
A little four.
That's going to make it pretty tough for Sergey to win. He's looking for a straight. Well, that ain't it. Double up. Joao Bauer. Double up to six big blinds. Seven make that.
Nah.
Do not get involved.
So, like, not a fan of Kenny versus Spenny at all?
What?
Not a fan of Kenny versus Spenny at
all? I've never seen it, but I was saying it was a race. Kids in the Hall versus Kenny versus Spenny.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
It was weird to pick a word that had verses in it. It was not really well thought out on my part. Joao's all in with his ace. Here comes Sergey. He calls with jacks.
Pair of jacks.
Yikes. 16% chance for Joao, who spikes the ace on the turn.
No.
Queen.
I told you, Joao Bauer never loses.
We'll never finish it.
Jack Bauer never loses, and neither does Joao Bauer.
Checking stats. He lost to Fabrice Soulier 4 days ago. Oh.
I told you. He gets out of that chair somehow every time.
But they can't sit in the cube, so he's not even in the chair.
I mean, doesn't this look like the sort of torture chamber they would throw him in at CTU?
That, Jack, you're correct.
Unfailingly, always somehow manages to get wrapped up and considered to be the bad guy. Jaffe Poker says, don't call it a comeback. He never left. John Paul the Great says, Joao has gumption. Sergey happy to take that one down. 12 big blinds for Joao. And he flops pretty good.
Pretty good.
Okay, so Ted wanted me to make one thing clear to you. I've been letting it fly that you've been calling him my agent, but he says, tell your friend I'm not an agent. A manager shows up for an important client, an agent would just send his assistant.
So he's your manager?
Yeah.
He should also clear up the fact that you and I aren't friends, Joe. And Ted, Joe liked that joke, so maybe you should be my manager.
It's funny because it's true.
Yeah.
Ooh, I like it when Sergey looks at me.
Yeah, he's fine. Oh, he's gonna look at us again. It would be a great tell every time he has a hand, he looks at us.
Wink. Sergey 7, still good. I'm not your friend, pal. That's what he wrote back. I'm not your buddy, guy. Get her, Ray.
We're kidding, guys.
Sergey, what a nit.
We're buddies. We're kidding.
Who's buddies? Us?
You and I, yeah.
So Pappy Van Winkle chimes in to say, Eric, this is the match I meant would go 150 hands. We were on pace to go 150 hands. We're at hand number 61 here. Blinds are huge.
Huge.
We got the best blinds. They're huge. Joao manages to outflop Sergey. Hiya.
Wow.
Sergey call a small river bet. Not a small river bet, a pot size bet, and he does call it. That's gonna flip flop things again.
Jack.
Ooh, not quite. How's that possible? It didn't seem like a big enough gain. Oh well. Joao 15 big blinds, 20 for Sergey. I guess at this point, these blinds are so big it doesn't really matter all that much. Ace queen high, still the best hand, still dominating Sergey. Sergey has very few ways to win this pot at showdown, but he's going to bet it anyway, it looks like. And gets a fold from the best hand. Well played. 1,400, 2,800. We are almost maxed out on the blinds for this 63-hand match. A double gutter for Joao. Flush draw for Sergey. We could see a pile in here. We've already seen the raise. Pile it in is correct. Big decision for Sergey. Wondering how far behind he is, how often.
No. I played bad. I thought you will shove me.
He's getting gonna have to fold this, right?
Well, Sergey's technically the statistical favorite by one whole percentage point.
Right, good bet.
And folds. Now we're gonna see a change in the chip lead, yes? Yes. 18 big blinds for Joao Bauer, 16 for Sergey. Joao puts them all in with Jack 10. Sergey's gonna have to fold. In my home game, we call 10-5 the hand that never wins. Sergey limps in with ace jack. Joao may get pre-flop trapped. It's a tarp. Ooh, and folds. Pretty interesting 15 big blind poker being played here.
And a change in the chip lead.
Pretty good flop here for Joao.
Jaffe poker incorrect. Stapes does have a home. I do not. Free agent.
More of a halfway house. Where do you get mail delivered? Your parents' house?
Yeah. All the bills go there.
I've been there.
Yeah.
And you can't have many bills, I assume. You got car insurance?
Nope.
Got a cell phone?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
That could be my only bill.
Netflix?
Yeah. Okay, yeah, those things.
They don't sound a bill, though, right? They're just...
Pornhub, browsers.
Oh!
Yeah.
You actually subscribe to those?
I do not.
Oh. I was thinking about it. Treat myself. Joao turns a straight. I think Sergey gets away from this. He does indeed. Line 1,600, 3,200. Huge.
This could be trouble.
Joao's raising King 8. Sergey's got him dominated. It's Domination Nation in favor of Russia. He is all in. Joao folds, though. Did I see they have 15 big blinds apiece? Yes.
We're even, Joe. We're back to even.
What's the record for most hands played in a match? We got to be getting close.
Over 100 between Fabrice Soulier and Aaron Paul.
This is going to be very close for number two, then. Looks like Joao's going to bet his tens. Sergey cannot call. Fold like the wind. Eric?
Oh?
Why is there an ante?
Being serious?
Yeah.
To make sure there's action.
But what, I mean, why not just make the blind slightly bigger?
No, to be fair, I like, believe the initial the concept did not have it. Well, I'm not the expert, but
okay.
We did work with Igor Kurganov, with Timex.
And they thought there should be an ante,
right.
Even though it's heads up and everyone's putting in the same ante every time.
Yeah, okay. But there's, apparently just activate some action. So yeah, it was to...
Okie dokie, two pair for Joao. Math Meister asks, wait, hands played in a match or in a game? We're talking about a game.
Yes.
Talking about one round. No.
Fold. Sean Paul, I don't care what your comment is about. You just said Seth Rogen. Happy Canada Day, Seth Rogen. Joe, he's not listening. What are your thoughts on Seth Rogen? Funny or not?
I'm for him.
Okay.
Especially because we might have the same management.
I think he's great. I think he's really funny.
I actually thought he was awful when he was on Freaks and Geeks. I was like, this is like the worst actor I've ever seen in my life. But obviously...
Because then you realize he's not an actor.
Right, well, he's a funny guy. He's become an absolute powerhouse. Yeah. So. Oh, hope people are calling me a really terrible actor on a really great show one day.
Yeah.
Sergey's got to ditch the seventh deuce, and he is dwindling. He is getting shorter than the kitchen counters at Warwick Davis's house.
A deuce. Oh.
Come on, a Willow reference? Already? Help me out here.
Not big on Willow.
Let's go.
Pussy Willow from...
All in and a call. Domination Nation. Although opportunities arise frequently in these little baby ace situations.
Whatever.
A big card. That means we're chopping this pot up.
Chop it up.
And you know what they say, Eric? Some people occasionally are not that mad at a chop pot.
Am I allowed to say that? Is this a registered line from the Poker Stars Live team? Or
I'm just changing it up a bit, okay, just in case there's any intellectual property issues.
That's what I'm asking. Hey, look at this. Look kinda who's like wishing Canada a happy birthday. Elkie, who says they're some of the nicest people in the world, and we should be proud.
You know, Canada's pretty good. I'm not going to lie.
Canada did allow 19-year-old Joe Stapleton to enjoy life Montreal.
Blinds at 2 and 4,000. We have maxed out on blinds. No more blinds. This is as big as they get. My favorite thing about Canada, right, is that when you're in Canada and you're having breakfast and you run out of maple syrup. And you go...
Seven big blinds.
I'm trying to tell a story here, Sergey.
And he's folding.
You didn't say anything the whole match. I launched into a Canada anecdote. A Canada-dote.
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 Yeah. All right, Chase.
Okay. So what I like is that when you're having breakfast in Canada and you run out of maple syrup, and then you go get more maple syrup, when you come back, your cell phone's still on the table.
Yeah.
That's my favorite thing about Canada.
We're good.
And when it's not still on the table, it's because someone's, hey, I thought I looked like you may have dropped your phone. Hey, can I? Sorry that I took a minute to bring it to you.
Here's $5. I'm really sorry.
Hand 87. Wowza, says John Paul the Great. This could be the one. This could be the one. Yep. Here we go.
There's blood everywhere. But he's going to double up. It's not over.
Blood in the cube.
Whoa!
It does appear.
Look at Filatov.
No. Bam. Not that.
It does appear as if Sergey is going to be the one to double up.
Yes. Ace.
No, he'll 10. Take it.
Magic Man says Stapes and Dennis make huge bank doing this job.
Just not even going to weigh in.
Call.
Three high.
Folds the best hand. Joao, big fan of my hand.
You know what? I won't say what me and Eric make for doing this job, but I will tell everyone that I lied to my manager about how much I was making.
Gone.
He just left. He's gone.
King high holding.
Queen.
It's over. It is over. 90 hands. How is that even possible? Well, that was a marathon. 90 hands. Goonies never say die, and neither would the short stack in that match. No matter who it was, just kept doubling up. I will say that for the most part, it seemed like the best hand was winning. It was just like these really marginal, obviously, situations. A little bit weird that we saw things go that long.
You'd think that Lebedev, that caught aces twice and kings twice, would have been in full control of this match, but that's not what happened. And Joao Bauer, his internet poker experience really proved to be right here. Playing with smaller blinds is something he's very comfortable with, or sorry, higher blinds, but less chips. So smaller big blinds.
I mean, one of the things that you need, it's like you need so much to go right in poker, right, for you to win. Like not getting aces is not enough.
Right.
Not only do you need to get aces, but you need your opponent to have enough of a hand to pay you off in aces, and also not enough of a hand to actually beat you.
Right, and when you do play garbage like deuce three and you hit a straight, that also is great. So that's what happened with Bauer at one point as well. So you know, that helps. So,
do you think,
but 99% of the time that never works, right?
Yes, I agree with you, stats man. Do you think that there is any more truer, like, cliche in all of poker than about pocket aces and how that they're designed to either lose a huge pot or win a small one?
I mean, parts of it, but I'll take aces every single hand.
Yeah, of course you would, but yeah. I don't know. It does seem to work out like that pretty regularly.
You're right.
That, like, you're like aces, and like everyone folds, or you're like aces, and someone's like queen 10 suited. I'll take your money.
Right.
Thanks very much.
No, you're right.
So that's why I think that, again, just, you know, not necessarily waking up with huge hands all the time. You don't have to. It doesn't help you necessarily, not all the time, especially in heads up, because there's only one guy out there. And if he doesn't catch a hand, or if he doesn't decide that he wants to bluff the out of you.
Well, the other issue, and you sort of alluded to that, is that when you do have aces heads up, you can't just, you know, you can't re-raise seven times the blinds because the guy's just going to go away. So if you do re-raise two or three times, then the other opponent is usually going to call in heads up. So that person
That's
is
a good
really
point, Eric.
Ahead of the game as well. I just had a poker reference. Can someone clip that? I sounded intelligent when it comes to poker.
That's been I don't know if I would go that far.
All right. Thanks, Joe.
I mean, it was good. It referenced poker. It's smarter than
good.
Me.
I no, thought it was pretty good.
It's definitely smarter than I sound most of the time.
No. Come on, buddy.
I don't.
Hey, buddy. Look, can you do the accent? Because I can't do it. Hey, buddy.
Come on, buddy.
Yeah, I like that. I like
thanks
that.
For having me, buddy.
Yeah, that's how we sound.
A couple of buddies down there with Laura in a second.
Hey.
As we celebrate Canada Day.
It's great. It's great Canada Day.
I saw you had been working on a batch of maple syrup.
Which is really hard
when we
here.
Got here, yeah.
Since there's no maple trees.
I know.
But I did go through some of those beautiful palm trees, and it's going to be palm syrup.
Palm syrup.
It is boiling in the back of the house. What's good about Las Vegas, you don't need any sort of oven or anything. You just leave it outside during the day and evaporates, and it becomes maple syrup. You know, maple syrup, one of the only rare things that raw vegans sort of ignore the fact that it's not 100% raw because it's so delicious and good for you. And it's got a lot of.
I saw you have a bite of a biscuit this morning, my friend. That wasn't raw.
No. Yeah.
Neither raw nor vegan.
Well, actually, could be vegan. Biscuits, a lot of times, do not have butter.
They don't have eggs in the batter?
No. God, no. No.
Well, there's sausage that probably touched it. An egg, too.
Did you notice I picked it from the top? Oh, we're ready.
All right. Well,
baguette is vegan.
Sergey Lebedev finally won that match after 90 hands. He is celebrating, and he is on the floor with Laura.
He is indeed. Congratulations to the Moscow Wolverines. I didn't know what was going to go on there. You were in head, you were going to win, then Joao was going to win, then you were going to win.
It was incredible. We finished at blinds 2-4. I think it's not often happens in GPL. I started very well. I mean, I had a lot of good hands. I had aces, I had kings
back to back.
Back to back, yeah. I had jacks, I had good hands. I win a lot of pots, of course, because Joao didn't have so good hands. But then I played too tight some spots. I lost some all-ins, and I was a little bit uncomfortable because of new experience, play life, but not at the table with dealer. I didn't understand sometimes exactly stacks, and some I played, I think, one bad hand with my flush draw. I didn't like it, but finally, it was great. I win all-ins and I won. Yeah.
I know. And your manager, Anatoly, we could see him in the shot. He was out here. He was getting quite stressed as well.
Yeah.
But are you happy, Anatoly?
Oh, yeah, I'm really happy.
Okay, he's good. He can breathe a sigh of relief. And you're more comfortable now. You know how it works.
Yeah.
You're going to go for game two.
Yeah.
You know how Joao plays now a bit better.
A little bit better, yeah.
So you're ready for game two?
I know that he can surbat me with three deuce off and win. Okay, let's see.
Let's see. You still haven't won it, but if you win the next game, then it's all yours.
Okay, I will run good.
All right, Sergey Lebedev, we are going back to you guys at the desk just after this quick break.
Can't get enough of the GPL? Head over to globalpokerleague.com for the most complete and up-to-date standings, schedule, stats, and information on your favorite team, as well as full-length match replays, highlights, and epic hands from all of our matches, and much, much more. We'll be right back.
is moving slow.
Welcome back to the GPL Summer Series. Joe Stapleton, Eric Dennis. Eric, your good friend, Math Maestro, has pulled a clip of your poker brilliance, but unfortunately he can't put the link in the chat because it gets deleted. So my suggestion to you, my friend, and other people, tweet it with the hashtag GPL, and that way anyone who's searching that timeline, like Eric, like myself, we can click on it.
That'd be great.
And if you wanted to make it a link to something more interesting, that's okay with me, too. I just mean, like, nudity-wise.
Well, yeah, that would be better.
By the way, how much do you love the Russians? Sergey Lebedev, man.
He's fun.
These are fun guys, fun team. Breaking that stereotype, and I like that. You know what I always say? I think Russia's just kind of America East. It's, like, very similar, at least in the mentality, in that you got, like, you know, a massive country with a bunch of people in the middle are kind of but there's, like, a lot of other really cool people in the country. Okay. That's all I'm saying.
I'd say they're more like Canada, because they're really nice and...
You wanted to go with Canada?
Well, we're both from very cold countries, and we both love hockey.
I mean, it's almost illegal for Sergey's last name to have the word gay in it. So that's something that we want to...
Yeah, that's not going to work.
Not very Canadian.
No.
Justin Trudeau, he would not stand for that, buddy.
He would not. He's a great guy.
That's not cool, friend.
He likes his green juices.
We got the player. They're in the cube already. Let's go. Let's just get going with the next match. So far, Russia's up 3-0.
Wolverines, Joe.
It's amazing how fast they get the guys in the cube when I get political.
Yeah, that's
true. Get down there, get in there now.
Yeah, usually we have to wait like 6 hours.
Can't trust Steve's. Oh man, so much fun stuff being talked about in the Skype chat, and I don't know what I'm allowed to read and what I'm not. It's so hard.
In a Skype
chat? I don't know what to do.
Am I involved in this?
First of all, Laura Cornelius loves Willow. I don't think she would be upset for me to tell everyone about that.
The next part.
I am the greatest swordsman who ever lived, Eric Dennis.
Oh, Laura just said, you shall not pass. You will not read that.
I will not read that.
I mean, Laura tweeted or let us know about a player that's won an EPT event. That's about it. Might be from...
Laura, why don't you come in here and tell that story yourself?
It would be great. Hold on. Twitch chat, would you like Laura to come here and tell us the story she just told us? And with more graphic details, of course. Oh, yeah, Anna Kournikova, love. It's Pedro. That's all we're asking. Alex Ovechkin, Sergei Fedorov, two great Russians.
Hey, good job, Jaffy Poker, connecting Willow to the poker world. Kevin Pollock, one of the brownies.
Love it.
How much for the baby?
All right. Everyone wants to see Laura. Wants to hear the story.
Laura, 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 Laura.
But an EPT legend.
Ace King doing pretty good here. Just going to go on record and say that.
It's a strong holding here, especially knowing what the opponent has, and that doesn't matter because it's the best hand.
I stole it from a stupid daikini. Racist. Racist Jaffy Poker. The thing is, Joao's obviously got the nuts here, but Sergey, like, can't hate his hand.
No.
A pair and a draw to the nuts, like, okay.
He's cooking numbers.
Sign me up.
He's going to raise this. Whoa, what a callback. I am on fire today with my poker analysis.
Bing. Whew. Happy Canada Day, buddy. Thank you. Did you see that dude who got booed off the stage at the Montreal Comedy Festival? I think someone might even tried to attack him. He's a dude that comes out on stage. I don't remember his name. And his opening line is, "Greetings, moose bleepers."
And we'd be offended by that?
And then he goes, "You know what's the worst thing about Canada is that half the people speak French and the other half of you bleeping let them." And then he like got booed off stage.
Really?
Yeah.
I did not see that. The Just for Laughs Comedy Festival coming in a few days?
Somebody up there, somebody must have seen what I'm talking about. So Sergey does not get there in the end. His pair of deuces is not looking super stellar on this board. Does Joao really think that Sergey is going to be raising a set very often? That's the only thing he's losing to. It was a set on the turn. That's now a full house. Or quads.
Guacamole, is this Canada Day? Yes. The day that I remember my comedy hero, John Candy.
Aw. So my one friend that I have.
Two.
Ooh, okay. Sergey's thinking about this. Wait till he falls. There we go.
That's two big laydowns. Sergey's going to get upset here.
That is not a big laydown. It's a pair of deuces.
No, but twice that he's actually thought about doing something. And he made a big raise here, Joe. Let's not forget.
So my one friend who worked on SCTV just reaffirms that John Candy was one of the most beloved human beings of all time, not just by audience, but just no one has a bad word to say about that dude.
He's the best.
Here's a funny Tinder story.
It doesn't involve John Candy and or Eugene Levy, because I date Eugene Levy because he's the boss.
No, but one of my friends was once in Portugal. And she was swiping on Tinder, and she said she matched with 65 guys named Joao. And I didn't believe her, and she showed me.
I did not think that's where you're going. I thought you were going somewhere else. I thought you were going to an EPT champion. That's where I thought you were going with that. Yeah, I guess a popular name. Two of them are in our league, so.
Yeah, we got two Joaos right on the team.
Got a nice handshake from Joao Somau yesterday.
Joao Somau. Joao Somau. And Joao Bauer from Sao Paulo.
It's a good looking cat.
He's kind of a wiener.
Is he?
Yeah. Not anyone that is on the screen right now.
No, of course. Sorry. God, I went with EPT Champ. I wasn't sure. It's confirmed that I have no life, that I would remember that.
Man, I've got a great story about an EPT Champ that I gotta wait till I leave the industry before I can tell anybody.
You don't have to name names, buddy.
No, because if I even give the details of the story, someone will be able to figure it out. People are smart. I mean, they caught the ultimate bet cheaters. They're gonna figure out my story.
I mean, they caught them, but nothing happened to them, so.
That's true. Joao's gonna be pretty happy with top pair here, being bet into. Sure thing, buddy. You're in. ANB says Joao is like John. Yes, says Pedro. But even though,
even
in a place where there's the name John, it's pretty hard to match with 65 people named John.
Johns or Michaels, there's not.
All right, Math Maestro has got the link posted to the hashtag GPL stream.
And Joe, to be fair, I've only matched here with 7 Johns, so.
Yeah. Look at you, Eric Danis.
Why am I so much shorter than you when I'm not really that much shorter than you? Oh, look at that over there. That's nice, the little logo. That's
it's
nice.
The camera does it to you, man. Like, I look like a midget compared to James Hardigan.
Well, he
apparently
is
that's an offensive word, by the way. I'm sorry,
yeah,
I just used that word.
Yeah.
I look like a short person.
Yeah.
A very short person next to James Hardigan.
Sean Newcomb asking, what is Portuguese for Kyle? See, those are just the sort of jokes that I like.
Sergey's turn two pair. He needs some pots here. He's got about a 2-1 at chip disadvantage.
Speaking of pots, I've got a funny one for you, but it's got to be off air.
Okay. Maybe we should stop teeing up these stories that we can't actually tell. Maybe we should make a truce.
Okay. But it's good for us to remember telling each other those stories.
Although, or I could just do it like yesterday when there's like a member of the media standing around and I'm just talking a whole bunch of garbage about people. That was really smart. Hey, today's the birthday of Adrian Mateos Diaz. Buenos dias, Adrian. Yo soy el comandador.
Happy birthday, Adrian.
Happy birthday.
So he's like 22 today. It's ridiculous.
Eric. I must go.
Nice.
Oh, Pedro.
Vaya con Dios.
Pedro, that's not what I meant. No, I'm sorry. It has nothing to do with the illicit drug.
I was just walking my manager out to the parking lot. Did I miss anything?
No.
Could have sworn I saw a flash of a sombrero.
No.
And a poncho.
No.
Okay.
Maybe. Our boss is very touristy.
Thank you for that, Le Chiffre. And thank you, flopping the joint, Sergey Lebedev. ACR True Trooper asks, what are they playing for? They're playing for the dominance of the Global Poker League. And at the end of the season, there is a $100,000 first place prize to the top finishing team. Cha-ching.
These two cities or players playing for cities are also playing for countries, Brazil and Russia. Both very well represented in the GPL and the poker world. Brazil is booming with poker right now.
Brazil's big time.
Yeah.
I'm half hoping, half not hoping, that I get sent to a tournament in Brazil from my overlords at some point in the next couple years. I'm just afraid I may not make it back.
No.
So Joao does not catch it straight. He's left with Jack High. It is no good. Which I know is a shock with Jack High that it would be no good at showdown, but sometimes it happens.
Joe, we were talking about biscuits earlier. I frequented a young lady who's vegetarian, however, is a very bad vegetarian, does not cook, which is not a good thing.
No, my God, if you don't cook and you're a vegetarian, you see French fries and pizza, right?
Yeah. So she started taking classes, and the first thing she went to was a French class, and they taught her how to make croissants, and she said, you know, there's like a lot of butter in those things.
There's like almost a stick of butter, isn't
yeah,
there?
Yeah, of course. That's why they're so delicious.
Blech. All right. Joao flops a 5. Sandy Sanchez says Joao doesn't follow through with any of his bluffs. I hadn't noticed that, but maybe we can pay attention to that going forward.
Le chiffre, c'est des croissants. Oui, je le sais. C'est des croissants.
Well, he's talking about,
pas dire croissant.
No, he's talking about Fabian Croissant.
Oh, he's a guy. I like him.
Fabian Croissants.
Yeah, and he's got an amazing beard.
Thank you, my babies. Thank you for remembering some of my stupid bits.
I remember now. I chose to ignore that one.
Do not forget Fabian. He will get cross with you.
I always get him and Gruesome crossed up.
Yeah. I feel like the Twitch audience is a good cross section
of like
society.
It.
Joao's 5 still good. And he calls. But lo and behold, Sergey makes another straight. High nose dodo, hi highly caffeinated, hi stubborn gaming.
big game. You guys have been, you guys are still rookies with Stapes then. He goes way back.
Arugi says it best. Nothing is funner than going runner runner. Unless you're talking about going to the movie Runner Runner, in which case lots of things are funner than that.
Did people do that?
There was actually a guy on The Bachelor this year, The Bachelorette, one of the contestants, who listed Runner Runner as his favorite movie. Right?
Wow.
And I feel like Runner Runner is probably like the modern day equivalent of Boiler Room. Remember Boiler Room was like that real bro-y, like douchey.
Yeah.
I think that's probably what Runner Runner is like.
But then you do have bro-y like Swingers, and that's just brilliance, right?
Correct. Absolute brilliance.
I was like, oh my God, Joe didn't like Swingers.
Swingers is my all-time favorite movie.
It's amazing. They play NHL 94 throughout the freaking movie.
Okay, another poker anecdote for you as we see that Joao has a pair of nines here. So I've worked with Jeremy Roenick a couple times.
You have?
On the PokerStars.net Alumni Charity Poker Tournament.
Yeah, that's what it is.
Is the full title of that.
I also have a follow-up for you, too, because you were really classy about something I tried to set you up for, and you never went for it. Go.
I've worked with Roenick on that, and Swingers is my all-time favorite movie, so of course I had to ask him about the scene where they mention him. And Roenick, I'm sure Roenick's a Trump supporter because he's a hardcore Republican, but he also speaks like Trump, like in the way that he's like, everything's like the best or the greatest, and... He's like, oh, I'm good friends with Vince Vaughn. Real good friends with Vince Vaughn. Yeah, he's texting me the other day. Great friends with Vince Vaughn. I'm like, okay, man, that's awesome. Because, you know, obviously Roenick played for the Blackhawks. Yep. And Vince Vaughn's from Chicago.
Yeah, diehard Blackhawks fan.
Yeah, so it was cool getting to chat with Roenick a little bit about Vince Vaughn. Joao now out-chipped 2-1 by Sergey, and he's likely to lose a few more chips on this pot unless he can catch a 7. The good news is that he didn't catch the 7 on the turn, which means he's going to win more chips with it on the river.
Yeah, that's right.
What were you looking to bring up?
Oh, yeah. The first year you and Jeremy worked together, they sort of made him the lead guy or the expert, right?
Yeah, okay, yeah. And,
let me just say it because it was very hilarious. And I interviewed you that year, of course, being Canadian, a hockey nut, and a Sportsnet guy, and I literally gave you 3 opportunities to throw him under the bus, and you refused. You were just all class, because you worked with him, and you know he's a nut, and still huge, even though he's 45.
No, he doesn't scare me at all. Like, I just think it's unfair.
He was one of the scariest hockey players ever, by the way.
No, he definitely doesn't scare me at all. Like, because I'm like pally with him at this point. It's fine, but like, I definitely wouldn't throw him under the bus on Twitter. Like, some people would just write like, oh my God, like, get this guy off the air.
Right.
I think it's unfair to take him and throw him in that situation and be like, talk about poker, and then like ridicule him
right.
for not getting some of the things right. My favorite thing that he used to do, though, was he would say, this is a great call, but he would say it in like the general term of call. Like, he didn't actually mean, like, someone would raise, be like, oh, good call. This is a good call. Meaning like the decision is a good call.
Very, very good hockey term, actually. Right. That's where you get that's funny. Yeah, poor guy.
John Paul the Great says, my all-time favorite hockey player is JR. Currently rereading his biography. He did say what you just said in his book, Verbatim Stapes. About Vince, Jeremy, the name, and Wedding Crashers was in honor of JR. There we go. Trips for Sergey, straight draw for Joao. Big chunk of his chips to call this off. And when he misses, he's going to be left with queen high. Jaffe is calling for the 8 on the river.
Screaming for it.
Yeah, the last time we did that poker tournament, they had JR play, and then they had me and Hardigan do it.
Yeah, but that was much better.
I did it with him 2 years in a row.
We saw Vanessa Russo win that tournament.
Twice, I think, she won it.
She's great on there.
It's kind of silly how hard she tried. Like, Daniel's in there goofing around. Right. Jonathan's
Duomel
like,
going, just having fun.
And Vanessa's taking it very seriously. While folds the straight draw, decided he did not have enough chips to continue speculating. Blinds at 6 and 1200 now. Joao, sub 20 big blinds. 20 Biebers.
Biebs. Laura Cornelius admitting to us that she got her blackjack advice from the movie Swingers, and that's why she's broke. Yeah. Next time, Laura, when you're at the Rio, just to stop Andy Block for a moment, he can give you some pretty solid advice. Now, what Laura did not mention is, Joe, she did participate in a huge blackjack tournament back in the day. That is,
Eric,
you can't find that online.
That's African-American Jack? Unbelievable.
That can be found
online. It's 2016, Eric. Unreal.
Laura eliminated by Paul from Suffix. I was very upset by that.
Suffix.
I don't know. I just invented.
Suffix is like...
I know. See, I wanted to say Essex.
My parents... Suffix came the out. Thing is, his grandparents were from Prefix, so...
I meant to say Essex.
But you confuse Essex and Suffolk, I think.
Maybe, yeah.
Sergey's flopped a boat here. Not much going. I look at he looks out at his fans.
And there he is.
Two something, Anatoly!
Oh, God, look at those arms.
Not that.
No, we don't want that.
This kid loves the camera, and I love him.
Yeah.
Sergey's jack high, still good after this flop.
Say 16.
Jaffe's pretty funny today. He finds it distressing that blackjack dealers are allowed to call the game one thing, but if a player tries to call it that, it's a big deal.
Well played.
Queen 10 versus 10-7.
Oh, Poker Nut. Yeah, we're sorry. We're calling them Biebers today in honor of Canada Day, and they don't get more honorary Canadian-ish than Justin Bieber.
Happy Canada Day, guy.
We took him back, by the way. Did you know this? Now that his new album is quite adult and really good, he's cool now, and he hasn't done anything
stupid in 3 months.
I've never
had issues with Bieber, at least musically. He did feel up my friend in a club after the American Poker Awards, actually. So after the American Poker Awards...
This year?
Yeah. Maria Ho invited me to a club in L.A.
Oh, I guess she didn't have my number? How did not...
You know, the table was really full and there was a lot of meat-based cocktails, so we figured that you weren't really going to be into it. And so in this particular club, the way the bathrooms work is like the sinks are sort of like unisex and the boys' and girls' rooms are on either side, so... My friend Heidi was there, and when she turned around, she was face-to-face with Bieber, who sort of grabbed her. Can we show this really quick? Can I show you the move that Bieber did?
Is this how Heidi was?
Yeah, he kind of did one of these to her. And she was like, no thanks, bro, and walked away. And then, like, he goes like, whatever.
Yeah!
He was like,
whatever, Heidi!
And I appreciate my friend Heidi, because she's... I appreciate her reaction to that sort of thing. Didn't freak out as if it was some sort of assault, even though he did lay his hands on her, but also wasn't like into it either. She was just kind of like, come on, Bieber, what are you doing?
Was he pretty gross and individual, kind of skinny and
I don't
weird.
Like people that just touch girls straight up, even if it's like on the hand.
I got you.
I used to date a girl with a lot of tattoos. People used to walk up to her and touch the tattoos.
Yeah, that's got to be offensive.
Joao loses a big one. Missed a lot of stuff there.
Oh, no. Pappy, no. Pappy saying you watched 10 minutes of the new match game last night with Alec Baldwin.
There's a reason why these shows are always coming back, because they always, every time it fails. Like, they're just... ACR True Trooper does not know who Justin Bieber is. Probably fine.
A shout out for my good buddy, Eric Louis Saez, or translated Eric Louis 16, who is watching live on Twitch. says I'm sounding good, bro. That means the Ricolas have been working. Thank you, Joe.
Ricola.
Well, Joao Bauer has been in this situation before. He did make a bit of a comeback in game number one, but ultimately succumbed to Sergey Lebedev. We're only at less than half the hands it took to finish the last match. Yes, Eric Danis.
Can I give you my brag from the American Poker Awards?
Please.
I ended up in a room, well, in Liv Boris / Igor Kurganov's room, and was playing chess with both of them and Fedor Holtz. And my good friend Ophelie.
After the American Poker Awards?
Correct. We ended up in.
I was invited to that room.
Yeah, you didn't come.
I did not.
Yeah, I was there. To which our good friend Ophelie said that I was pretty terrible at chess. I don't remember playing. Apparently, Igor and I were an item for the game.
Yeah, he'll do that.
And
that's why I didn't go.
Yeah,
it's a predator.
Fedor and Liv.
I think.
Fedor wasn't number one in the world back then, so yeah. Wasn't too impressed.
So weird. If I could only tell you what I was doing at that same time.
What,
but
you were
I can't.
Bieber.
Sure, it'll be on a blog eventually. Pocket nines for Joao. Ace four for Sergey. We could see this go all in. Joao's just limped in. He's waiting for Sergey to jam on him. That's a trap. Oh, three clubs on the flop. Not so good for nines.
Oh, more outs.
More outs. Correct, Eric Denis.
Fire today. Not one of the outs.
How do you run pure there?
You see Anatoly there? Oh my God, he's upset.
And
oh,
now
God,
we're back to where things were before. Two shallow stacks. Lines are 100, 1,000, 2,000, nearly even.
Laura Cornelius asking us not to mention that room, Igor and Liv's room. It's weird, I did not see Laura Cornelius there.
What Laura just wrote is the reason I didn't go.
No, it's not what you think.
Slothra says this is starting to turn into name dropping. Starting? I'm just trying to tell some relevant stories, guys, to keep people entertained during this rubber match.
We mentioned Kara Scott at the top of the show, Canadian. Happy Canada Day, Canada.
Happy Canada Day, pal. Friend.
She's our buddy.
Buddy.
It's name dropping to me.
Thanks for having me, buddy.
Magic Man, keep it clean. Joseph is a good guy.
It's close.
Queen high. King high. King six. In three.
King Never. Eight is not the best hand.
Wouldn't bluff. King high. Check the time. Okay. Good bluff.
Butt Farm Poker says, I'm not your guy, buddy.
Hours, Joe. That's good.
A lot of it was crying. Joao turns a straight.
Probably I lose.
Just to list off a few more players that were in that room.
Mm-hmm.
Joe.
Go ahead. Keep the name drops coming.
Canadian, Marc-André Ladouceur.
He was in
Happy
the
Happy Canada Day. Anthony Zeno. Anthony
I
Zeno
love
is there.
Me, Anthony Zeno. He is such a nice boy.
The big Z.
He was very drunk that night.
He was. He disappeared, too. He left. Yeah, he left early. I saw him the next morning, actually. We hung out.
Thank you. He was asking about my friend Heidi, who came with me. Same Heidi. And I would love to hook him up because he seemed like a real nice boy. My one issue is that I wouldn't want my friends to date a poker player at all.
That's terrible. Yeah, no offense, guys. Except Anatoly.
No, major offense. Yeah. Major offense.
Heidi, is this the friend we met day one?
Yes.
Yeah, she's great.
Love me some Heidi. No, just a friend. I like having hot girl friends.
Oh, I get you. Me too.
She's a great wing woman. In fact, the night after the Aaron Paul match, we went out to dinner at Aria.
Is that when you tweeted the picture?
Yes. And I ended up having to take her out of the bar because she was adamant that I talked to the girls at the table next to us. And they had just been harassed by a guy, and I sort of, like, saved them.
Yeah, good job.
And she's like, now you do it. And I was like, no.
Oh, but you were. You had the, that was a good, you were.
What happened was this guy was harassing a couple of girls, and security eventually made him leave. And then I saw him come back into the restaurant. And so instead of letting him come back in, I immediately got up and sat next to the girl he had been sitting next to. But then I couldn't, in good conscience, then hit on her myself.
You would have needed her. She should have done that.
Well, according to my friend Heidi, she was, but I was like, let's just get out of here. Joao's pair of threes, no good. Pappy Van Winkle, a great wing woman is worth her weight in gold, says Pappy. He is correct. Joao folds his hand. He's back under 20 big blinds, especially now that they are 12 and 2400.
Wow, not much.
Butt Farm, you should have been with us a few days ago. Joe's retired from Tinder.
Well, I am for now, but I will say this. After the GPL is over this summer, I will be doing, we got an all-in and a call.
Yeah.
We'll go over this later on.
We will. I've been writing this down.
Ace high holding. Oh. Sergey's the player at risk, I think.
My one beeb.
Queen on the river. Sergey doubles up, and that's going to leave Joao with like a chip and not a chair. He has zero big blinds, according to our count. He's all in. Dark. Queen 9 is probably going to win this hand. It's very, very likely to win this hand. I don't almost see any way that... Yeah.
That's not the way.
That is not the way. Game 2 over. Game 2 also going to Russia. So now things are starting to get kind of dicey for Sao Paulo. They are facing a clean sweep.
Yeah, New York is only 7 points back, so they're really not helping the cause at the moment. 133 hands through two of these games. Oof. Here, Joe. Pappy did predict a 150-hand match. He predicted it for the Lefrançois-Ketai match, but he did predict this was... So he just terrible prediction. He just messed up.
No, I mean, he said 150 for the match. So
no, but he had said that yesterday. So he said, today I mean
it now. Oh, today.
Now
I mean now it today.
I mean it. And he's right.
I'll allow it.
You good?
Yeah, I'll allow
good job.
It.
Happy Canada Day.
You know, I wanted to throw something out there really quick before we get down to the interview is that I noticed that Sam Grafton said he's about to start streaming. How dare you? How dare you, Sam Grafton? You try to go up against us? You go up try to go up against us and take away from our two dozen loyal viewers? Unbelievable.
No one leave.
Unibet, more like unibrow because I'm angry, like evil Bert from Sesame Street. Stay with us. Don't go to Sam Grafton's.
No.
I'll go there. I don't care. He's an entertaining
guy. He's got great
guy.
Music, though. He plays a lot of good 80s music.
Does he?
You shouldn't go there.
How does that work on Twitch?
Well, I don't think he can rebroadcast. I think they do get banned. Not banned, but you cannot rebroadcast those. I think live, it's like, it's happening.
Okay.
But you can't rebroadcast because of copyright infringement.
Stuff's going to go down eventually one day, I think.
Yeah. You know what? You know what? Grafton, we're on you. He's playing 80s music. Cops, time to get to Poland. That's where he is.
Oh, you want to send Interpol to pick up Sam Grafton?
Yeah, stealing music.
And stealing our viewers. How dare he?
crime.
I do. You know what? I do like Sam Graffin, though.
He's a fine man.
I kind of wish he was here.
He's a very intelligent man.
He's a little too fruity for me. You know what I mean? Like a little too.
That's no word you can use, but okay.
No, like he's just into. Is that not a bad? Is that a bad word? He's too frou-frou. He's too. Yeah. He's too lefty. He's like
classy,
you know,
intelligent.
No, oh. No. I just, you know, he's a little too open-minded for me. You're watching the GPL. Let's just cut to the interview. Go.
Thank you so much. Congratulations to the Moscow Wolverines. Another 3 points, meaning now it is a win today for you. Congrats.
Thank you.
Tell us about this game, because it didn't last quite as long as the other one. And Joao almost was down to nothing again there.
Yeah.
But he came back before, but he wasn't able to come back this time.
Yeah, it was a little bit the same. I catched a lot of nuts in first, I think, 15, 20 hands. I catched straight. I catched a lot of trips, full houses. But every time he folds in the right moment, and then blinds going up, he trapped me with nines. I had ace, and it was pretty short, so I going all in. He trapped me, he won with nines, and it was the same stacks. So it was flip, king queen against a7. It's not the flip, he was a little bit ahead, and he was ahead before the river, so he can win. But I was lucky again on the river, and then won. Yeah. He played very well, but I was lucky and played well also, I think, I hope.
And we have one more game available, meaning you can now do the clean sweep. You didn't need it. You were top of the conference anyway, but I imagine that 9 points is going to make your manager very, very happy today.
Yeah, of course. I loses all three to Randy Leon and Anoka. I understood that I play now different opponent, but still I want to make a revenge for me, if you understand. So to make 3-0 against someone else, maybe against Randy, someone.
Well,
sometimes.
We'll find out if you are able to do it and take the full 9 points. I'm sure Joao Bauer is not going to let you do it that easily, though. He's smiling at us right now from the sidelines. He will try his best. This will be the third and final game here inside the cube for the Moscow Wolverines versus the Sao Paulo Metropolitans.
Can't get enough of the GPL? Head over to globalpokerleague.com for the most complete and up-to-date standings, schedule, stats, and information on your favorite team, as well as full-length match replays, highlights, and epic hands from all of our matches, and much, much more.
Explosions in the Sky. It's the summer anthem
of
2016.
Yeah.
As far as royalty-free music bed commercials go.
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah,
pretty good. Except for that, we do like a little Cake by the Ocean, you know.
I do like Cake by the Ocean, but we can't play that one because, you know, that one's like a real song.
And it's a Jonas Brothers song, so we're going to get sued.
Yeah, no, as far as bargain basement songs are concerned, Explosions in the Sky.
It's a great song, though.
Is the way to go. So we got one game left here in this match between the Wolverines and the Metropolitans. And right now, Joao Bauer is just hanging on for dear life. He's just trying not to get the bagel hung on him.
Yeah, 7-point lead are the Moscow Wolverines now up on the London Royals. And you mentioned earlier the Sao Paulo Mets are digging themselves a grave. There's only a 7-point lead on the Rounders, and they want to catch up. Doesn't look, at this point, Joe, it does look like it's going to be a Montreal LA 1-2 finish in the Americas Conference. But Sao Paulo could recover, but with just a strong start by Felipe Ramos, it's just been a little rough for the last few games, so we'll have to see what happens next. What's that coy smile there, buddy?
I'm just trying really hard not to cough.
I see.
I got a tickle in my throat, and things are getting...
Oh, and we have to stall.
Getting weird.
Okay, yeah, okay, go ahead.
So, yeah, I don't know what happened.
Joe, I know you're choked up. Someone asking on Twitch who's playing on Sunday for the LA Sunset. Well, it's Olivier Bousquet making his Cube debut against Wei Yi Zhang. Michigan State Spartan. I cannot wait to talk to him about how he got to Michigan State University. That is fascinating to me. I think same graduating class as Ryan Reese.
He's from China?
He is, yeah.
So from China to Michigan State, that's like a pretty obvious, clear path.
Maybe other schools, but Michigan State? It's an engineering school,
I'm kidding.
I don't know.
I'd love to know the story as well.
Yeah. Like, he didn't play. I don't think he was a football player.
I don't know. I'm trying to think of what the title of that movie would be, but I probably won't get there in time because you know why?
Yeah.
Our players are down in the cube. Let's go. Game three starts now.
All right. Sergey saying hi again to us. Speaking of hi, Joe, you were talking about Tinder.
What was I talking about?
Oh, by the way, before you go, you did say you were retired for the moment and someone called you the Brett Favre of Tinder, and that is just delicious.
That's pretty good. All I'll say is that I'm currently working on a new project that should premiere at some point in late July that involves me and Twitch and Tinder.
Why would you have to be off? Oh, to get maximum value.
What's that?
Well, why would you have to be off Tinder?
I'm just off Tinder in my personal life, but I need to get back on for a project I'm working on.
I see.
So that's why Tinder will be back.
And Joe, you've slipped a few words to me about this project, and I think people are going to be excited by this.
Yeah, I think it has the potential to be real fun, so.
Agreed. Kids, I'm a little jealous. Joe has a few projects on the go that seem quite exciting.
Well, none of which I'm actually being considered for, except for that one, because it's my idea. But
that's right. But the other one from this morning, that's a good one.
Yeah, also, like, you know, they don't even know who I am yet. There's a very small chance I end up working on that, but we're going to give it our best shot.
Do it.
Ace 5 is the best hand, also the best draw.
Joe, that Zhang Bousquet match will be followed. It's doubleheader for Sunday. Will be followed by Byron Caverman, Sao Paulo.
Captain Caverman! Sorry about that audio.
Against a Rome Emperor. We still don't know who that is. We're going to find that out in the next few days.
I hope it's Commodus.
Yes. That will be the start of the final heat. We're almost done, buddy. That's crazy how fast things have gone.
Yeah, well, you know, things are, when they're really fun, they go by very quickly. And I'm happy to have brought that funness to the table here for the summer series.
You know, I'm glad that you believe that when you're having fun, things go fast. Because yesterday, something happened with my girlfriend, and it didn't last very long. And
really?
I was trying to explain to her that, hey,
it's really
fun. Yeah. I just heard Poker Central had to bleep that out. It really wasn't that bad.
Oh, big race.
It's a big race. Can't.
Is Letter Kenny related to Kenny versus Spenny? Is it like this? Why does everything have to be called Kenny?
I don't know. Yeah, that's a good question.
Joao Bauer. Kapow, 3-bet, 7-8 suited. Sergey going nowhere. Much like gluten allergies, he is sticking around annoyingly with his ace-10. He does have the best hand, but Joao is continuing. Still don't think Sergey can fold this right away. He calls with what could be the best hand already, is very likely to be the best hand now. Sergey and the Moscow Wolverines looking to go 3-for-3 against the Sao Paulo Metropolitans. So far, so good, Sergey.
Yeah, life is good if you're a Moscow Wolverine.
Sergey flops best here as well. If I could, by the way, if you guys are at all interested in that project I just mentioned, if you want to give me a follow on Twitch, if you want to follow my channel, that'll be the best place.
I'll be honest, Joe, you remember my friend Blackpool, who was
Blackpool,
here yesterday?
Correct.
He could be the only person I follow on Twitch. Of course, the GPL. But actually, I can't do this from this account because I'm on the GPL account. Remind me after. I do not
sure,
follow
buddy.
You. I will
I mean,
follow you.
I didn't mean you. I just meant more for the babies at home.
No, but I want to. I want to be notified when you're on.
Yeah.
Because, you know, with our schedule, sometimes we forget about what time of day it is.
I believe my Twitch name, Butt Farm Poker, is Joey Stapes. Ace King versus 10-9 suited.
Don't type.
I'm gonna type. I just won't send.
Please.
I did this last time.
Yeah, yeah.
Do you not like it? Do you want to just do it on your own?
Well, it's been going great, but
okay.
No. But I'd like for you to.
You
can see
what
you
I suggest.
Yeah, of course, I like it.
Sergey flop stop pair.
We haven't been to the point of actually asking out, and she did watch yesterday, so she
keeps
watching.
It's time for that.
I think so.
Yeah, that's where I was gonna go with this.
If you're watching, I'm sorry. And yeah, she did find you very funny.
No, what are you talking about, Cyrano?
No. She mentioned that you were funny when she watched yesterday.
I appreciate that.
Yeah, we've been... they pulled the plug.
You gotta handle the action if I'm gonna do this.
All right, let me talk about things and do the Joe voice.
Yeah, hello, top hair.
Is your manager still here? Did you just leave?
He's gone. By the way, he said...
SOB.
He said, excellent work today. Got to run. Tell your partner I'm sorry, but I don't rep kids. I think it's a short joke.
Oh, I actually like that. Damn, here I thought it was a compliment that it looked
you
so
would
good.
Actually be two pair.
Someone's all in.
And Joao cannot call this.
Yeah. Yeah, great starting hand, but at this point...
You need another five cards.
Yeah. Which you can touch that button for five more cards. Nah, he's just putting on a show here. For his friends in the crowd.
Oh, nice hand.
It is a nice hand, isn't it?
I was like, I was for games. Good game.
But he did call!
Oh, wow, it's over. It's over, wow. Totally misread that one. Went for the hero call from hero 2-0, quite literally.
We did not get to 150 hands, I'm totally shocked.
That is nutso that those first two matches lasted so long and that one did not. Where were we on that one?
Seven hands. Pedro, you were wrong again.
Seven hands.
Sorry, that was Pappy. Pappy.
It's okay. Look, Pappy, don't...
Can we not give these guys a hard time once in
a
while?
No.
Oh.
No, these are nice viewers that
are
supportive of
I'm
the show.
I'm a huge fan. No, of course.
Plus, I'm glad because, you know, I got things to do today. Tomorrow's our day off. It's our weekend.
If you
know
type things right,
your phone drives me crazy because it doesn't do autocorrect.
Right. I don't like that.
And so it takes
I'm
me,
pretty intelligent
it takes me like
and I
10,
like to correct my own grammar.
It takes me 10 years to write something because I'm used to it just fixing the things as we go.
If we can take a few minutes. You understand
can't,
that
but go ahead.
I type in both French and English, so that's the reason
oh,
I
yeah,
can't.
Oh, yeah, because it messes with it, right.
Right, because then something like café becomes vulgar.
Right,
like how does that happen?
I tried to write, I tried to call a young lady an empanada dulce this morning. A Spanish girl that I'm talking to.
Oh, that's not, yeah, that's
and that means she basically told her I called her a stuffed potato. So when I tried to write that, autocorrect took over a whole bunch of times, and I couldn't get the words out the right way. So I get when you write in multiple languages, but like I just spelled the word backwards wrong.
B-A-K-C. Oh, I thought you were going to go with somewhere else.
No, I didn't send it either. It's fine. Anyway, quick recap of what we saw today. We saw an absolute sweeptacular.
It's three in a row. Three sweeps in a row.
Nine total points for the Moscow Wolverines. Hanging that big, delicious carby bagel around the neck of Joao Bauer. So that is good news for the Wolverines. Terrible news for the Metropolitans, who are their season's in question.
Yeah, it's great news for the Rounders, the Rush, and the Moneymakers, as the team that is ahead of them in third place has not collected any points. As I mentioned earlier, the Rounders are now 7 points back at even. The amount of games played is even, so there's a chance there. There's also a chance for the LA Sunset to really capture some breathing room as Olivier Bousquet is in our final match of Heat 5 on Sunday. So if he can win at least 6 points, Joe, that's a huge lead. That's a 19-point lead on Sao Paulo. So it does look like Sao Paulo, for the moment, third place is what they need to concentrate on. But this is a big, the big bagel is going to hurt them at the moment.
All right, well, we are going to hear from the clean sweepers, both Sergey Lebedev and his manager, Anatoly Filatov. They are down on the floor with Laura.
Well, it's another clean sweep. That's the third one we've had in a row now. 9 points going for the Moscow Wolverines. Sergey Lebedev, that was so much quicker than the other matches.
Yeah, last one was easier. I started well and I doing well and I catched again each flop, each turn, each river. And I think finally Joao was a little bit tired with it and made a hero call, was wrong. I was lucky all three games. I hope in main event WSOP I will run so hard as today.
I was saying at the beginning, wasn't it, how important is it to be winning on a winning streak? It really helps to keep winning these games, huh?
Yeah, it's really important because right now I'm like played 14 tournaments and cashed only once. So it's really important to hit this.
Sorry, Anatoly. But you can be proud for your team, the Moscow Wolverines. You must have loved watching Lebedev play there.
Yeah, we're leading the division. That's our place right now, the real place that we have. And we'll continue to do that with Sergey and other guys.
What did you think to the all three games as a whole, the whole match?
We ran very well and Sergey finally. And Joao, he folded too much, he was tired about that, and when like you have Ace King, the huge hand, and you miss the board was like okay to bluff cash sometimes because it was busted flush draw and like a lot of broadways in Sergey's hand. But
and it was one moment, I don't know was he thinking about it or not, but usually I value bet smaller and here I go all in, it was about the pot. And probably he saw that it's bluff more often.
But he just catched second
player. Maybe.
But you're happy with how Sergey played there?
Yeah, of course I'm happy. He's the best heads-up player in our team. I guess so. Like Vovtroy is also good.
You're also good.
Yeah, I'm okay.
You're all right. Sometimes. Now the Brazilians say vamos. What did the Russians say?
Вперед.
Заноси капусту.
Can we do a dance?
Отдайте деньги.
Давай.
Yeah, that's how it goes.
Whatever you want. Yeah, which one you prefer?
No one word for it. Yeah, you can.
Иди сюда.
Yeah.
There's no song.
You have
or
to
dance?
Say иди сюда.
Иди сюда. There you go. Congratulations once again. 9 points going to the Moscow Wolverines. These guys are going to have a good weekend, I am sure.
I am going to have a good weekend. But first, let's go over some of the league standings, see where we stand. As we take our day off tomorrow, we are dark one day, then come back to close out heat number 5 on Sunday with a doubleheader. We are going to close out heat number 5 and start heat number 6. But before that, what's happening?
Yeah, one team left to play in each conference, Joe. The LA Sunset is a team on deck with 122 points. They don't have any shot in hell at joining the Nationals at the end of this series, more than likely. But 122, they need to separate themselves even further from the Metropolitans. The lead is 13 points right now, sorry. And that lead could really extend itself with Olivier Bousquet in the cage later on this week. Again, the Sao Paulo Mets a little disappointing there with 0 points today. And Joao losing his last match. match, only 3 points in the last two matches. And Felipe Ramos had started the things off so well for that team. So we'll have to see what happens. Byron Caverman makes his appearance in the cube for the final matchup for the Sao Paulo Mets early next week.
Turns out VAMO stands for zero.
Yeah, there's a lot of
zero points for Sao Paulo today. Let's take a look at the Eurasian standings.
We should probably take this time, Joe, to talk about Anatoly Filatov. It's unfair that he's wearing that shirt and those guns. That's a little unfair to you and I, and it really upsets me.
It's unfair to those of us that are attracted to women and are happy that way, because now I'm having all kinds of doubts.
Yeah, Anatoly's a good-looking guy. And what about Sergey Lebedev? I want to bring him home as a fun toy. What a good guy.
He's
fun.
That's all I meant. Oh, my God. I will talk myself into some pretty... Is that you're signing a resignation letter right now?
It's my Letterman.
That's Dennis Miller.
But Letterman does it too. Dennis Miller, Letterman. And then you had Norm MacDonald, Canadian. He'd be like, hey, I got the pen. I'm doing
it. So you know who makes a joke like that? Crack whores. All right. Anyway, that's my Norm MacDonald for now. Again, I haven't been working on these guys. So.
Do you know where Norm MacDonald wasn't a legend? Is high stakes poker. He was pretty bad.
I loved him on the show, really?
but he replaced a legend.
I'm a Norm MacDonald apologist, what can I say?
I love Norm MacDonald.
Let's take a look at the fight card for Sunday. Remember, we are dark tomorrow.
He was on a show with Faith Ford. That's how good Norm MacDonald was
for
a while.
Yeah, he was.
The Hong Kong Stars, Wei
Yi
Zhang. Yeah, Wei Yi Zhang gets in there facing LA Sunset superstar Olivier Bousquet. It almost looks like Zhang is being fed to the wolves here. Poor guy. But Zhang did have a good performance, actually, after a subpar heads-up match against Max Pescatore while he was trying to final table a big event at the EPT Monte Carlo. He has made up for lost time. So Zhang plays then, and then we have the second half of that doubleheader as we kick off Heat 6, as you just said a few seconds ago.
That's right. Doubleheader Sunday. Nothing going on tomorrow except for me getting very, very drunk by the pool at the Hard Rock. Come by and say hello. I don't mean that in any way, shape, or form. Do not come mess up my game. Eric Dennis, I hope that your game goes well.
Well, we'll see.
Yeah, we hope that we have some things happening for you over our weekend here. I'd like to thank our players today. Thanks to the manager. Not mine, the manager of the Moscow Wolverines, Anatoly Filatov, for being here.
Thanks for Ted. He took notes. I saw him throughout.
Thank you, Sergey Lebedev, for being here. Thank you, Joao Bauer, for Laura Cornelius, and Eric Dennis. I am Joe Stapleton. Smell you later.
Can't get enough of the GPL? Head over to globalpokerleague.com for the most complete and up-to-date standings, schedule, stats, and information on your favorite team, as well as full-length match replays, highlights, and epic hands from all of our matches, and much, much more.
Slow.